Tourism Australia ad.
So everybody, how are you?
Aussies cried foul, saying she made her sound a bit kind of, you know, bogan. But some would say you're not dinky die unless you tweak your twang and sound as true blue as this old mate.
What the flaming hell's going on?
Now, if that sounds like you, you'll be spinning the dummy over the latest federal government push to soften our slang in the office. Multicultural Affairs Minister Kate Lundy launched the Harmony in the Workplace Guide last week in an effort to make offices more inclusive of migrants. Social analyst and demographer Mark McCrindle has conducted several studies on Aussie language. He joins us now for a yarn. G'day, Mark.
Good morning.
I love
G'day. Tell us more about this Harmony in the Workplace Guide. I mean, is this important?
Well, it's a recognition that one in four workers weren't born here, and in fact the nations from which people have come and now call Australia home continues to grow. So the workplace is more diverse than ever before, but the document does smack a little bit of the political correctness, and I think that's what's got people talking about it.
Yeah, one of the guide's main goals is to stop bosses from calling migrants ethnic because it might be offensive. Is that really the case, you reckon?
Well, that's a bit of a 1980s term. I guess cultural diversity is more the term that's in vogue today. But I think Australians don't really need much of a lecture on how to welcome. We are one of the most culturally diverse nations on earth. We've been throwing the welcome mat out there for more than half a century, and most people are pretty embracing of their workmates from different parts of the world, and I think that's a positive thing. Not denying one's own culture, but explaining the language is probably key, and finding out about other cultures, but not putting together a list of what's in or what's not appropriate.
Okay, well, let's look at that list, because there are some slang terms here which have been deemed too offensive. Let's take a look at them. Take us through them.
Well, casual swearing was one of those that was particularly mentioned. The guide actually points out things like this machine's cactus, or spit the dummy, or even bring a plate as terms that won't be well understood and perhaps worth avoiding. But, you know, I think it's probably going too far to put words on a hit list. Most Australians, and I think part of the richness of our culture is the language, and I think the goal is to, you know, use it, not neglect it, not hide from it, but make sure we're clear in explaining it, because there is a lot of irony around the Australian language, and new arrivals certainly, you know, find it a little bit perplexing. So do sometimes younger people as they hear the old timers use these phrases.
Okay, Mark, thank you very much for that. Appreciate
it. You're welcome. Cheers.
Thank you, Mark.